and flat out on the Cresta Run. It needs maximum concentration just to keep on the track. Now, you can get the thrill of high-speed sliding anytime you want. And that's only for starters. Fasten your seatbelts for the most swirling, swinging, sliding, spinning, up and down ride of your life. But where to start? This monster carries 45 victims. The automatic handrail effectively locks everybody into place, but do they really need it? What are their chances of actually falling out if it wasn't there? Wait and see. When it's up to full swing, the speed at the bottom is a frightening 35 miles per hour, backwards and forwards every 3 seconds. And the G factors? Well, a 10-stone person will feel 30 stones at the bottom and a mere 6 stones near the top. So you are never actually weightless. But let's take a closer look at just what happens at the point most people fear, the top. Nobody is falling forward. In fact, all their arms look quite relaxed. The handrail isn't to stop you falling out. It's there principally to stop you fooling around. Now, how about going for a spin? The centrifugal forces are pushing the riders right into their seats. Again, their weight will feel different. They'll feel slightly heavier. 80 years ago, this sort of ride was the big thrill. Nowadays, we take our spins differently. It's called the Enterprise Wheel, and the screams must be music to the ears of the thrill engineers. It's certainly a popular ride. What makes it thrilling is one thing, what puts most stress on the body is quite another. Watch what happens to the passengers and the capsules. Now, where do you think is the most stressful part of this ride? Well, it's not here, even though our 10-stone rider may be enjoying the funny feeling of going from 7 stones near the top to 27 stones near the bottom, all in about 2 seconds. The body is most stressed here, and the thrill machine designers had to get it just right. Riders sit in a knees-up position for one very good reason. The height from their brain to their feet is less. When they spin horizontally, the G-force is constant, spinning them out. And their blood is wanting to spin out as well, away from their brain. If their feet were further down, more blood would drain from their head, and they might well have a grey-out. All colour would go. But sitting in that position, at that speed, they're quite safe. And spinning can produce another surprising effect. Giles may only be 13, but he knows a trick or two. Watch the floor. It's as if he's held to the wall by magnets. As the drum gathers speed, Giles and Phil are thrust against the wall. The drum will be up to speed when it's spinning 30 times a minute. They're now experiencing a G-force of about 2.6, going directly outwards. And that force, plus the friction between their clothes and the wall, should effectively glue everything to the wall. Lower the floor. When you've had enough, we said to Phil, throw in your hat. But of course he couldn't, could he? Now for the third ingredient, sliding. Let's follow Rebecca down the tube. She sits on her mat as best she can. Her main preoccupation is to stay on that mat and not lose her balance as she goes round the bends. The slope is only about 6 degrees, but she's now travelling at almost 20 miles an hour. But how to make it more exciting? Go faster. Ian is a high-speed merchant. Not only does he start much faster, but he's cutting down friction by not using a mat at all. It's difficult to see, but he's trying to slide on only his heels and shoulder blades, reducing to a minimum the area of his body in contact with the tube. In fact, he's so fast, the camera can't keep up with him. Riding these rapids is far removed from the real thing. There aren't really any submerged rocks to tip over your boat, just special effects water pumps to churn up the flow. But it seems realistic enough. Believe it or not, the boats were designed to prevent the riders getting too wet. The height they float can be adjusted by inflating the ring a little more. But then they realized keeping dry wasn't exactly the name of the game. Riders seemed positively to enjoy getting wet. So they added a new feature. Not exactly high technology, but it works a treat. The free fall machine. You drop vertically 87 feet. You will accelerate away with the force of gravity, 32 feet per second squared. Here, you're falling to Earth at 55 miles an hour. As a ride, it's described as the nearest thing you'll ever find to walking off the top floor of a skyscraper. And there's no shortage of volunteers. Once it goes, unlike many thrill rides, the victims don't scream very much. They can't. They've left their breath way behind them. You go up 120 feet. After the free fall section, the cage will drop along a similar shaped curve to the one in the children's slide. And it's this curve that helps to slow the cage down. Breathtaking stuff. But if you're looking for swirls and swings, slides and spins, there's only one runner, the roller coaster.